questions, and I call on Deputy Micheál Martin, please.
Thank you, Alaska and Corla. Taoiseach, education is the bedrock of our democratic society and the key platform for our economic and social development. The role of the teacher in that context is crucial, as the quality of the learning environment is dependent on a regular supply of quality teachers and their retention within the education system itself. Pay equality for new entrants to the teaching profession is a very important factor in both recruiting new entrants to the teaching profession and retaining existing members. There is, whether people would admit it or not, a crisis in teaching supply at the moment, particularly at second level. There's been a drop of more than 60% in applications to postgraduate teaching courses between 2011 and 2017. There are real concerns with shortages in key subjects such as maths, science, Irish and languages. The Association of Community Comprehensive Schools has warned that students' subject choice and the quality of teaching was at risk unless teacher supply was tackled. And again, language, maths, science and home economics instanced. The Irish Primary Principals Network saying surveys showing real difficulties in recruiting substitute teachers at primary level. And the pattern is repeated across the country, with Dublin being particularly problematic. A survey by the Catholic Primary Schools Management Association found that 90% of principals had experienced difficulty in sourcing a substitute teacher this school year. Seamus McConray says the evidence is in, the debate is over, we have a crisis in primary schools. Ger Curtin of the SDI saying oral examinations facing challenges as a result, and the Education Training Boards Ireland again saying shortages will affect subject choices. And the situation is compounded by the housing crisis, the inability to buy houses anywhere near close to the schools that people teach in, the high cost of rents, and it's compounded by the high insurance costs. So young entrants and young teachers entering into the profession are facing unprecedented level of costs in cities and elsewhere in particular, that is compounding the situation in terms of pay inequality. Now, we asked for a report as part of the Public Service Pay Act and Pensions Act, and that happened. That report is published and has outlined the challenges that exist in terms of this issue, about a 200 million round cost, 68 million for teachers, about 60 million for teachers, about 80 odd million for education generally. There has been some progress, I acknowledge, in narrowing the gap, but there is still a very wide divergence. And given the crisis in recruitment in particular, I'm asking the Taoiseach, can he outline when talks will commence with the trade union sector in terms of outlining a roadmap for the restoration of pay equality for new teachers and new entrants generally?
Thank you, Taoiseach.
Thanks very much. I think I'm correct in saying that since the Fine Gael Independent Alliance independent government came to office, we've managed to increase the number of teachers employed by the state by about 2,000. So we've 2,000 more teachers working in our education system than we had just under 2 years ago. So overall, we're able to recruit teachers, but we do acknowledge that we are having difficulties in some areas, particularly when it comes to substitution and certain specialised subjects. And I think that's in part because we have taken on so many additional teachers, and many of the younger teachers who might have been subbing in the past are now in full-time jobs or are now taking up permanent positions. We've already made some progress towards pay equalisation. Back in 2016, Minister Bruton concluded an agreement with teachers' unions, and that provided for a pay increase of between 15 and 22% for newly qualified teachers. And those increases kicked in January 2017, and most recently, just in January 2018. And that now means that a newly qualified teacher straight out of college has a starting salary of just under €36,000 a year, which is not a bad starting salary for a graduate when you compare what's available to graduates across the private sector and other sectors. Notwithstanding that, we acknowledge as a government that there are 60,000 public servants now who joined the public service since 2011. Those public servants are on lower salaries than their peers, and that does create a difficulty. When we entered into pay restoration, and we have pay restoration now across the public service, pay increases in most of the private sector. When we entered into pay restoration and pay increases, because of the sacrifices that Irish people made, because of decisions that government made that made that possible, we decided we would start with the lowest paid, and that's where pay restoration started, and that was done with agreement with the trade unions. But we do acknowledge that there are now 60,000 people, some of whom are 7 years in the public service, who are on a lower salary pay scale. And we acknowledge that creates difficulties, creates discord in the workplace, that some people are on a different pay scale to others. And we're also very conscious that among those 60,000 people are younger people, often in their 20s and 30s, often people who struggle to face pay very expensive bills, like rent, for example, struggling to save money to buy a home, and also often face very high childcare costs. So bearing that all in mind, the Minister of Public Expenditure has published the report and analysis on this, and it is his intention in the next couple of weeks, once the conference season is over, once the unions have had their conferences in the next couple of weeks, to begin an engagement and negotiation with the trade union movement with a view to achieving pay equality for public servants over a number of years. I should point out, as Deputy Martin rightly pointed out, that this would cost €200 million in 1 year, in return for which we would get no extra hours, no extra staff. So we do need to bear that in mind. So it's not the kind of thing we can do in one go or in 1 year, but we do want to enter negotiations with trade unions in the next couple of weeks to begin talks on a pathway to achieving that.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Mark.
Yeah, first of all, Taoiseach, I would make the point that in terms of when population increases, the number of teachers we employ increase as well, unless you're going to reduce the or increase the pupil-teacher ratio. So the extra teachers are as a function of retaining existing pupil-teacher ratios, although last year we were successful as a party in forcing the pace in terms of getting the pupil-teacher ratio at primary level reduced. But that said, in terms of the pay equality issue, one of the biggest factors is the high cost associated, particularly living in Dublin and cities across the country now, in terms of the crisis in housing and insurance costs for young people in particular, making really it almost impossible to eke out a reasonable standard of living. The rents are exorbitant. It's almost impossible now to buy houses, given the inflation and house prices in some of these locations. So teachers can't, you know, have to commute long distances to the schools that they're teaching in. And that's a factor across the private sector and public sector in our cities. Can I ask you, Taoiseach, can you be more specific in terms of the time scheduling, in terms of are you talking 2 years? Are you talking a longer period?
Right.
And
thank
when you say you're prepared to enter talks, can you outline, do you accept that this needs to be a specific, concrete timeline for all those involved?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
I think, as is always the case with negotiations, it's very difficult to set a timeline because that depends on the willingness of the two parties in any negotiation to be willing to compromise and meet each other halfway. Having been involved in some negotiations, I think setting a deadline yourself can be counterproductive in terms of negotiations, because then it makes it harder for you to get the outcome you want if you're the one who has imposed a deadline on yourself. So we're not going to set a deadline on it, but suffice to say that if the trade unions are willing to compromise and come to an agreement with us, just as we have done in the past couple of months, the government won't be found wanting. But this is taxpayers' money, and we need to bear that in mind. One other point that I would make, I think it is an important one. Deputy Martin's absolutely right to say that housing costs and rental costs are very high. They're high for younger workers and new entrants in particular. But we do need to be careful about this. We have been here before. I remember some of the factors that led to the last economic crash, where there was a cycle of increasing house prices, increasing rents, which led to increasing pay demands, which led to increasing inflation. And we all know where that ended. And we, as a government, are determined not to repeat the mistakes that were made by other parties in office. We need to make sure we do not end up in an inflationary spiral.